The other common problem is not downing, and we fix that again by introducing the plots command that there is no toy. And then separately, outside of the send-out picture, I introduce pressure to the plots command, meaning I'll introduce the remote caller from a distance for that down command. So first they have to understand it just in obedience, distance down, so sit plots from a distance, pair that with the remote caller, and then we have to teach it in drive. I'll teach it in drive plane fetch. So we'll throw the ball, let him go get it, come back out, throw the ball, and then we'll plot him fairly close to the handler at first. So throw the ball, again, off the Schutzen field, just at a park or a different field or a different picture than the send-out picture. No different direction on the field, just so you're playing fetch. You know, throw the ball and then plots, you know, when the dog's still 5-10 feet from you. Use the remote collar, they lay down, and then yes, and then they can go get that ball.
I have a long line, I got my tracking line on him, so I'll be able to throw the ball, send him, plot him on the line and physically stop him. As soon as he's down, he gets to go again. So we'll have him in drive. Ready? So miss a little bit. And hold him, throw it. Let's check. Yes. Come.
And then with this process, you got to proof it to where you're playing two ball with the dog, that you increase the distance away from the handler the dog is before you down him. So we'll throw the ball. We'll wait for 20 yards and then plots the dog.
We'll start off here. Yes. Let's. Yes.
And we want this under stimulus control, meaning at any point if I say plots, you have to lay down immediately. If you don't, there's going to be the consequence for not listening. So you can do this with a long line onto the prong collar, or my biggest fix for this is really the long line with the prong collar and the remote collar to teach them to not blow off the command. And when we say plots, you have to lay down immediately.
Plots! Yes! Come!
This will help eliminate the dogs having pressure in the send-out picture, meaning cueing them, you know, from the dumbbell before your send-out, that we're not really adding the pressure into that picture. But on trial day, if you have a strong plot out of that picture, that normally it sticks over into the trial day pretty nicely with the dogs. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Hope this will help you and your dog in your training. Again, don't forget to share, like, and comment below.